Hey everybody, Constable Harry here. I'm also joined by Corporal Francisco and Corporal Sasrakul. How's it going, guys?
Oh, good, good.
Good, good. So, the purpose of this video is to talk about the second annual Depot Youth Academy that's going to be taking place here in a couple weeks. So I've got Corporal Francisco from the Media Relations Unit who's heading up the Youth Academy, and he's just going to talk to us about some of the things that are going to happen. So first, what I'd like to ask you, Corporal, is when and where is the Depot Academy taking place?
The Depot Youth Academy is going to be taking place on Saturday, March 29th on the GTA4 RCMP Gaming Community TeamSpeak server.
Okay, perfect. And I guess we should go over the minimum requirements because those are... I don't want to say there's too many of them, but that's probably the bulk of the information that we need to make sure that is got across. So I guess I'll start off because I do know a bit of the basic information. Is you need to be between the ages of 13 and 15 years old. Unfortunately, we can't go any younger than 13 because the clan supports the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, which basically means that anyone under the age of 13 is basically not able to join our thing, our TeamSpeak or anything like that legally. So that's one thing. Another thing we want to make sure is that everybody has a working mic so that they're able to communicate in-game via voice, because if you can't, that's pretty detrimental to, you know, being able to train and everything like that. Is there anything you want to add, Francisco? I know there's a couple more, but...
Well, Senior Consul Harry, we also would like people to have a legit copy of GTA 4. We don't want any crack versions or anything like that. We want a legit copy, as well as your NAT type must be open, or else, well, people are going to start getting kicked from game and not going to be able to come back in. So an open NAT type is, it's required.
Right, yeah, thanks, Francisco. And just to touch on the NAT type thing, there's a lot of different guides you can figure out how to do when it comes to opening your NAT if it's not already open. One of those being by opening your ports, there's a lot of things you can do. You're just gonna have to Google it. There's no one answer as to how to open your ports. It's something that myself and a lot of other members have had trouble with in the past. So yeah, as far as that goes, and I think that's about it. When you get to the Depot Academy, I believe you are issued a special Youth Depot car pack. Is that correct, Corporal?
Yes, the cadets will be issued a special car pack, specially made for the RCMP Gaming Community Youth Academy.
Awesome. And now, what are some of the things that the Youth Depot Academy is going to cover?
Well, basically, the cadets will be going through a mock depot. With that, we'll have a chance to experience how our real members train. You know, we'll present them with a driving course and a couple of scenarios. Some of these scenarios are going to include some TSU, ISO, and GD scenarios. And at the end, possibly scenarios involving the Youth Academy cadets.
Okay, awesome. And I guess another question I have for you, Corporal Francisco, is how do you apply for the Youth Academy, and where can you get an application? When is the application deadline?
Well, to apply for the GTA 4 RCMP Gaming Community Youth Academy, go to our website, gta-rcmpclan.ca. Once you go there, search for the GTA 4 RCMP Gaming Community Youth Academy release form. Once you find that, you'll find basically the link to the application. All applications are due on Monday, March 17th. The interviews will be conducted between March 18th to 26th.
All right, perfect. And I'm assuming, again, like once the applications are submitted, those who have made it past the initial application process will be contacted with the information, with the TeamSpeak and etc.
Yes. So once they have filled out an application, they are required to leave an email so we can come back to them with the information if they have successfully passed into the interview stage. And of course, after the interview, to see if they have successfully passed into the actual academy stage.
Okay, perfect. And just one thing I want to mention to anyone who's applying. We want to make sure that you guys are putting thoughtful answers into your application and things like that. We want to you to be able to show that you can, apply critical thinking and things like that and, face challenges that we give you because that's, what's going to be happening in the UTEPPO Academy. So with that, I'd like to thank Corporal Francisco for answering my questions today. And I'd like to wish all who apply for the UTEPPO Academy good luck.